We've got our hands on the hottest off-roader of the year. It's the Bronco, and it's the right one. It's the Badlands Sasquatch. Let's go for a drive. Host Brian Max, racing driver, lover of driving fast, fun things. And on this channel, you get reviews for drivers from drivers. Now, this new Bronco certainly qualifies as fun, especially one with badging that says Badlands and Sasquatch, meaning that this will go pretty much anywhere. But this is an all new off-roader from Ford, and I hope I'm going to be able to do it justice. But given that it is all new, we need to look at this in a little more depth. How cool is it that in 2021, there's an all-new Bronco here? Mechanically, there's a lot going on here, so pay attention. You have two power choices. One is the 2.3-liter four-cylinder with a twin-scroll turbo, or the 2.7-liter V6 with two mono-scroll turbos. The four makes 300 horsepower at 5,700 RPM and 325 pounds of torque at 3,400 RPM on premium fuel. The six makes 330 horsepower at 5,250 RPM and 410 pounds of torque at 3,250 RPM on premium fuel. They do have slightly reduced power and torque output numbers on regular fuel for you cheapskates out there. Transmission choices are the 6-speed manual with the 7th crawler gear, or the 10-speed automatic for the 4-cylinder, or the 10-speed automatic for the V6. Given that this is 4-wheel drive, there's the center transfer case, independent front axles, a solid rear axle, and the optional transfer case that allows you to shift electronically. One of the cool features is that you can get front and rear lockers like on this one. Drive modes vary by Bronco model. This one gets the Magic 7, normal, eco, slippery, mud, ruts, Baja, sand, and rock crawl. It's worth mentioning that some of the functions like trail control and the trail turn are only available with the automatic transmission. This is a proper truck, so it is body on frame construction as you'd expect. The doors are removable, as you probably know, and they stow inside the vehicle. You don't have to leave them in your garage. Given that this is the Badlands, it has a ton of skid plates all underneath. In this spec, it wins the battle of the critical off-roading dimensions, ground clearance, all the angles, and water fording. Suspension is long travel, as you'd expect. Double A-arms up front, solid rear axle, and this is a Badlands, so it has the optional Bilstein position-sensitive dampers, as well as the sway bar disconnect. Steering is electrically assisted with different levels of assist. Brakes are 311mm rotors in the front, 308 in the back, and just single piston calipers, because this is an off-roader and you don't need massive brake calipers. Plenty of wheel and tire choices, but this one has the right spec. It's the Sasquatch, so it gets 35-inch tires in 315/70/17 on 17x8.5 wheels. If you're taking the doors off, unlike some of the competition, what they've done with this Bronco is put the mirrors on the cowl so they don't disappear when you take the doors off. There's lots of cool stuff like the cameras that have spotter views for off-roading, just brilliant. On the inside, there's loads of current and modern Ford tech, but forget about that kind of regular stuff. The infotainment system has trail maps built in. How cool is that? This one has rubber floors, and it's got drain plugs with marine-grade upholstery. That is just brilliant. Some people are already complaining about the curb weight of this thing, but it's only 4,600 pounds, which is a couple of hundred pounds heavier than its competition from Toledo. This will tow only 3,500 pounds, which is a bit of a disappointment given the boat that I was towing this summer and some of the other episodes you may have seen. It would not have towed that based on this rating, although it feels strong enough that it can tow way more than this. Not quite sure why it's limited to 3,500 pounds, but I'm sure some Bronco nerds out there will tell us. It's that time in the episode for how to spec your Bronco. Base price of a four-door Bronco in the United States is $33,450. In Canada, it's $46,249. Now, you guys know this is the Badlands Sasquatch. What you're looking at is the very fashionable cactus gray with a black interior. This one basically has everything. It is a Badlands, it has the Sasquatch package, it has the V6 EcoBoost, the 10-speed automatic, of course, that goes with the V6 EcoBoost, hardtop storage bags for the doors, the tow package, and a couple of other little things. With all of that in mind, this is pretty much the most expensive Bronco specification you can get. As tested, I think this is about $55,000 in the US, and Canada it's $72,639. Now, how do you spec back yours? Well, here's the thing. I think when you get something like a Bronco like this, you need to get the fully off-road capable one. You don't want a street spec one. You want something like this so you can go off-road. The only thing I will say in terms of specification, don't get this cactus gray. It's the most fashionable color. I think there are so many better color choices for your Bronco, some that are more subtle, some that will stand out, but just don't get the cactus gray. The first thing you need to know about seating position, especially with a Bronco on these big tires, is that you gotta climb up into it, especially for short dudes like me. I've gotta climb up into this. However, these grab handles that are all throughout the cabin make it a heck of a lot easier to get up and into the seat. Once you're here, visibility is just excellent. You can see everywhere, and of course all of the cameras help, whether you're parking or whether you're off-roading. The camera system in this particular one is very comprehensive and works very well. But once you're here, the seat is comfortable. Now, it doesn't have a lot of bolstering. This is not a corner carver, this is an off-roader. And one of the things I do like is this upholstery. You do slide around on it a little bit, but that's not the intent here. The whole point of this is that you've got a very durable, very cleanable interior. This has the vinyl floors as well, so you can keep this clean after your days of off-roading. There's more than enough adjustment in the steering column and the seat to feel comfortable and get a comfortable seating position. And I've got a great relationship to the steering wheel and to the pedals. One of the things I don't care for, and this seems to be a Ford thing, is that this steering wheel covering, maybe it's leather, but it seems durable, which is a good thing, but it doesn't have that fine feel of a high quality leather. But otherwise, this will work because this is an off-roader and it'll take all the abuse that you can give it. That's a good thing. The rest of this interior is very much suited to the character of this being a legitimate off-roader. You can keep it fairly clean because a lot of these switches all throughout the cabin are sealed so that if you get them muddy, you're gonna be able to clean them very easily. In terms of spaciousness, there's a lot of headroom. That's great. There's a decent amount of room in the second row, and behind that tailgate, there's enough room for storage. There are tie downs, and you can do all sorts of things in terms of carrying gear with this Bronco. But as I mentioned, it only has a 3,500 pound towing capacity, and I know I would want to tow a little bit more with my Bronco, that's for sure. When you first get behind the wheel of a Bronco, one of the things you notice is that there are a lot of refinements compared to the competition from Toledo. And I would have expected for this Bronco to be a little quieter on the road, but that's not the case. Certainly, given that this is the Badlands Sasquatch with the big tires, there's a bit of road noise. But at highway speeds, yes, of course, there's gonna be a lot of wind noise. Acceleration's not bad. It is not a rocket ship, that's for sure. This is, of course, the V6 twin turbo EcoBoost. We did try the four cylinder with the manual, and that was a little bit slower. It's significantly slower, but if you have to get your Bronco with the manual, well, that's your only option for the time being. Still, this one with a 410 pounds of torque, well, it gets up to speed relatively quickly, and that torque is always available. There's no problem getting up to highway speeds and that sort of thing, but really where this shines is at lower speeds, and in this specification, this is something you definitely want to go off-roading with. There's no question about that. When you're off-roading, it kind of doesn't matter, as long as you've got plentiful torque to get this over obstacles and around things and up and down hills, that works out just fine. I'm very interested to try this off-road. Hopefully we'll have an opportunity to do that soon. In terms of traction, this seems like it'll go anywhere. In the little bit of ultra-mild off-roading I've done with this, it'll go anywhere. No problem climbing little things and whatever, but I really want to take this off-road to see what it's completely capable of doing. Now, I did do an activation that Ford has with the Bronco in the States, and it's a really cool driving experience. I didn't have my cameras that day, but what they did, and if this event is anywhere near you, and I highly recommend attending, but it is so cool. It demonstrated all of the Bronco's fundamental abilities, its ability to ford water, climb, and and descend steep hills, and of course did the trail assist turn, and that was in a different situation. That was in some sand, so it was able to rotate basically on a proverbial dime on this hard packed sort of gravel mud situation. It's really not doing that, but in the sand that turn assist was immediate, just basically turned on a dime. Couldn't really find the necessary road surface to demonstrate that for you, but it is a very, very cool feature, especially when you're off-road and are in some tight quarters. Highly, highly functional in that way. Love that they've done this, and that is a very, very smart thing that the Ford Bronco team has done. The 10-speed automatic seems just about flawless. Yes, you've got manual control over the gears through this little shift button here on the left side of the shifter, but otherwise in regular operation, shifts smoothly, quietly, always seems to be in the right gear no matter what kind of driving I'm doing. I'm very impressed with the 10-speed automatic. Just works wonderfully here. We are driving the automatic at the moment, but I have to mention how that 6-speed with the 7th crawler gear works. The shift throws are quite long. It's very trucky in that regard, and there's not a lot of feel that comes through that clutch pedal. The great thing is, when you're releasing the clutch, the Bronco is instantly responding, so you get a reasonable amount of feedback when you're releasing the clutch. That 7th crawler gear is kind of interesting. I can appreciate how that'll work off-road. On the road, it's completely useless, and it's not intended to be used on the road, but the gearing of the 6-speed manual seems to work just fine in on-road conditions, and overall I was pretty impressed by it, save for the extra long throws of the shifter. As I mentioned earlier, this one has the electronically controlled transfer case, so shifting is easy. It's all done here, and that 4 automatic mode is very useful in climates like this, because in a few weeks we're gonna have some snow, so if you're cruising around, just leave it in 4 automatic and you've got all the traction you need in slippery conditions. Steering is what you'd expect for an off-roader like this. It's got a relatively slow rack that helps for off-roading. You can be a little bit more precise when you're going off-road, at least seriously. But otherwise, it is electrically assisted. Yeah, there's some different levels of assist. I haven't even bothered. I generally don't, because there's no need to do that with electrically assisted steering, because you don't get a lot of feel or feedback through the steering wheel, and that's fine. This is an off-roader. It's not a sports car, so I'm not expecting that either. Braking, on the other hand, is pretty confident. Good feel through the pedal, lots of power. It doesn't feel underbraked at all, and perhaps that's the reason why it's limited to towing 3,500 pounds. I don't know, but Ford engineers might be able to articulate that a little bit better than I can. But the braking on this is very, very good, very much above average, very happy with this brake pedal. Ride quality is something that we've got to talk about. This is the top specification, so it's got the Bilstein dampers, which do an excellent job with body and wheel control. And given that it is an off-roader, it seems a little more firmly sprung than it needs to be for the road, but for off-roading, this is exactly the kind of setup you want. We're going over some rougher terrain, in fact, a train crossing right here, and let's see how this does. And no problem, great body and wheel control. And your passengers are gonna be fairly comfortable here. No, this is no Lincoln Navigator by any stretch of the imagination, but it's still very comfortable for you and your passengers. The ride is dominated by a little bit of tire noise from these big 35s and a little bit of wind noise at highway speeds, because this is an off-roader. It's not a luxury vehicle. On the road, it handles like an off-roader, very tall center of gravity, so there's a fair bit of body roll, bit of dive under brake, modest amount of squat under acceleration, but these are the trade-offs you have to make when you're looking at an off-roader like this. Very capable off-road, so it's gonna lean a little bit like it does here in this corner. The flip side is that even in urban environments like this, it'll go over everything, and you don't have to worry about it either. These big 35s can just crush everything, and the suspension will absorb all the impacts. I love it for that, and it's a great kind of urban assault vehicle for me. I live in a city where there are speed bumps and potholes, and you simply never have to worry about those. This thing will crush all of the obstacles in your way in a regular urban driving environment, and then of course you can take it off-road and go far, far off-road. Overall, this is just the coolest thing that I think Ford could have done this year. This is a wonderful machine, very well resolved. I love all of the cool factor. The one big difference between this and the competition from Toledo is there's not a lot of whimsical Easter eggs, for example, throughout the cabin or throughout the vehicle. It's very simple and straightforward, very much Ford's aesthetic in that way, but that's okay. I love the styling of this thing. I think it looks very modern, very rugged. It looks like a Bronco should, and it's pretty awesome. My verdict? Well, at this point in the episode, we often talk about fuel consumption, and this is one of those vehicles that I simply don't care about fuel consumption because it's so enjoyable to drive. And speaking of driving this thing, everywhere I stop, it's getting supercar levels of attention. Somebody's got to stop me. Somebody wants to talk about the Bronco, and that's because it is one of the coolest vehicles you can buy in 2021. If you're an introvert, this is probably not the vehicle for you. If you want to break out of your shell, well, maybe buy a Bronco. It simply is a game changer. It elevates the off-road game completely simply because of all of its capabilities, all of the cool stuff that it does. And it's very, very modern as well. This thing is really unique. If you're looking for an off-roader, I highly, highly recommend checking out a Bronco. Thanks for hanging out with me today and having a look at this all-new Ford Bronco Badlands Sasquatch. Hope you liked this episode, and if you did, well, you're not new to YouTube. You know what to do. Smash the subscribe button, turn on your notifications, like this video, and as always, sharing is caring, so please share this with your friends, especially on Reddit, because on Reddit, they really need to see reviews for drivers from drivers. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them in the comments below, and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. If you want to support the channel, please hit up our merch store. Links here, links below. Lots of great stuff for driving enthusiasts like us, including our popular line of Save the Manuals merch. And thankfully, the Bronco comes with a manual. Nice job, Ford. Really appreciate that. Anyway, thanks again for watching. We'll see you again next time. And remember, cars don't understeer by themselves, not even Ford Bronco off-roaders.